The world watched and waited as the five-day window for North Korea's rocket launch began Thursday. But bad weather forced Pyongyang to delay the launch. Now on the line from North Korea is CNN correspondent Stan Grant, who is covering the rocket launch there. Thank you for joining us on The World Tonight, Stan.
Hi, Tina.
Yes. Can you tell us how the announcement for the delay and the reasons for the delay officially from Pyongyang was relayed to you?
We're not getting any official announcement. They've always said that the window for this launch was going to be between the 12th and the 16th. That gave them several days options there to choose the best time that they thought they were able to achieve this with success. So it was always going to be a movable option within those days. Now, there is some forecast rain, perhaps, tomorrow, so that may also be a factor in causing yet another delay. But when we visited the control center just yesterday, we were told that all was in readiness there. All the preparations had been made. The three stages of the rocket were in place. The satellite had been placed inside the rocket, and the fueling process was underway to prepare for this window of opportunity they had to try to launch this satellite. But of course, the debate continues about whether it's a satellite launch or, as the United States insists, a ballistic missile test.
Stan, having been inside that nerve center that you call, does it look like it is the real nerve center that would be able to monitor the rocket launch from now until the end of that window, five-day window?
Yes, a very good question, Tina. It was a very bare operation, maybe about a dozen tables and some people sitting at the tables with monitors. We actually put that question to an independent space analyst who said to us, yes, it did appear as though it was sufficient to be able to achieve that task. So while it didn't look as if it was particularly busy or a particularly large center, it is appropriate for that particular task.
Just how prepared do you think is South Korea in relation to this rocket launch? Would you have an idea from where you are now?
Well, we all know that South Korea, the United States, Japan, other countries have expressed concern about this, and it all relates to the intention of North Korea. North Korea insists it's a satellite launch, it insists it's for peaceful scientific purposes, and that it is its sovereign right to fire that satellite into orbit. Of course, other countries are insisting, no, there's something much more sinister here. This is part of an ongoing missile technology program. And again, independent space analysts that we spoke to said that's not really the question. The question here is the technology is of a dual use. Yes, it could be used for a satellite. It could equally be used for a missile. They believe this is, in fact, a satellite launch, but of course it could be used for another purpose. South Korea is watching this very warily, and South Korea and Japan obviously concerned about any impact on their airspace, even threatening to be able to shoot parts of it down if it poses a threat. The North Koreans have said they will try to avoid that airspace, and also said if there is some potential threat, the rocket, the satellite, has the capacity to self-destruct.
Okay, Stan, one last question. When will the world know whether it is a missile or a satellite that was launched?
Well, we really aren't going to know, I don't think. The North Koreans are insisting that it is what they say it is, a satellite. The United States and others simply refusing to believe them at this stage. It's going to take some while before we get some clarification on that.
Okay, thank you very much, Stan Grant, there, reporting for us on The World Tonight, the CNN correspondent who is now in North Korea.